This is the photograph of Felice Sperino, Senator Sperino, who was the man who founded the wine estate. He was a great writer about things about phylloxera, but I've never seen this picture before. This is the man from Paolo's great uncle?
He was a cousin.
A cousin. A cousin, okay.
This is his research about phylloxera.
Ah, so this is the work that he writes in 1881 about American vines as a way to resist phylloxera. Notes gathered by Felice Sperino, Biella, 1881. Phylloxera is this plant louse, this root louse, which actually came from the United States and attacked, it went first to England as attached to grape varieties coming from the East Coast. And from Kew Gardens in England, it came to the rest of Europe, beginning in France and then traveling throughout Europe. And it actually destroys vines unless they're in very special types of soil. If the soil is very sandy, the grapevines don't suffer phylloxera. Because since the little louse is burrowing, it can't burrow through sand because the sand collapses. But if it's clay soil, chalky soil, it can burrow very well. It actually killed all of the vines planted on their own roots, because that's how vines were planted originally, without any rootstock. It was decided after much work of how to save the vineyards that the rootstock, which came from America, would probably be the resistant way of reestablishing vineyards. So the rootstock went into the ground, and then you let it grow, you cut off the top of it, and you grafted the Vitis vinifera, the European wine grape, to the rootstock. And about 99.5% of the grape varieties in the world are all grown that way. So much damage was done that the Europeans thought that the wine industry would actually die.